Baby, I'm an animal, I can't
Good day, learners. From our previous video, you learned that matter is all around us, and it is classified into pure substance and mixture. You also learned in details the properties and classifications of a pure substance. In this video, we are going to talk about mixtures, so that we will be able to distinguish mixtures from pure substances based on a set of properties. Which of these pictures show a mixture? What helped you in answering the question? Many things around you are mixtures. Some are solid, like brass and rocks, liquids, like seawater and fruit juices, and gas, like air. A mixture consists two or more substances that are not chemically combined. Example, when you mix hot water and coffee, and when you add fruits to make a salad. In a mixture, no new substances are formed. Since the substances do not react chemically, the properties of the substances remain. A substance in a mixture may change in physical appearance, such as when a sugar is dissolved in water, but its chemical properties do not change. In a mixture, the substances retain their original properties, so you can distinguish one substance from the other, and you can still recover it. Mixtures can be separated by physical means. Mixture is classified into two, homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. You can differentiate the two classifications by asking the question, is the composition uniform? If the answer is no, then it is a heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture consists of visibly different substances or state of matter. The substances remain separate and distributed unevenly. Example, in a mixture of oil and water, you can still visibly see the two substances. The different substances in the mixture can typically be separated easily. Other examples of heterogeneous mixtures are cereal, spaghetti, salad, gravel and sand, pizza, and halo-halo. One type of heterogeneous mixture is a suspension. Suspension is made of larger and visible particles that do not dissolve. The solid particles will settle at the bottom and separate over time if left alone. Example is sand and water. That's the reason why some liquid medicines are needed to be shaken before drinking. Is the composition uniform? If the answer is yes, then it is a homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture is a mixture that appears to be the same or uniform throughout. The component substances are well mixed. The particles that make up the mixture are very small and not easily recognizable. One type of homogeneous mixture is a solution. Solution is a mixture of two or more pure substances. The particles that make up the solution are too small to be seen. Example, seawater, mouthwash, and tea. A solution is formed when one substance dissolves in another substance. Solute is the substance that dissolves, while solvent is the substance that does the dissolving. The solvent dissolves the solute. There is usually more solvent than solute in a solution. Salt dissolves in water. Salt is the solute while water is the solvent. Water is considered as a universal solvent. This table shows the types of solution. Another type of homogeneous mixture is colloid. Colloid is a mixture in which the particles are intermediate in size between those solutions and suspensions. Many colloids look like solutions because their particles cannot be seen. Colloids exhibit the Tyndall effect, the scattering of light by colloidal particles. These particles pass through a filter paper, but not through a semi-permeable membrane. Colloids can be made subtle by the process of centrifugation. Examples of colloids are emulsions, smoke, foams, milk, aerosols, fog, gel, clouds, toothpaste, mayonnaise, and blood. Comparing pure substances and mixture by boiling point, freezing point, and melting point. The temperature in which a liquid starts to boil is called boiling point. The table shows the boiling points of some familiar substances. Pure water at standard pressure boils at 100 degrees Celsius. But when you dissolve solid particles in water, the boiling point becomes slightly higher. Thus, the boiling temperature of a mixture is slightly higher than the boiling temperature of a pure substance. The increase in boiling temperature depends upon the amount of dissolved solute particles. These solute particles interfere with the rapid evaporation of solvent particles. Thus, more energy is required to boil a concentrated solution than a dilute solution. Did you know that before pressure cooker was invented, your grandmother used to add spoon or fork to the boiling mixture of meat and water? This is because adding a metal or any other substance increases the boiling temperature and consequently shortens the cooking time. Why is a coolant, a mixture of water and ethylene glycol, added to the radiator of a car during a long journey on a hot summer day? An increase in the number of particles in a solution lowers its freezing point. Freezing point is the temperature at which a liquid changes to solid. Different substances have different freezing points. A pure substance solidifies at a specific temperature. The temperature at which a solid starts to melt is called melting point. Pure solid substance melts entirely within a short period of time, but some parts do not melt when the solid is a mixture. The melting point does not change with the amount of substance. Example, a bulk of iron melts at the same temperature as a small piece of iron. Therefore, the melting point of a solid may be used to identify whether it is a pure substance or a mixture. The freezing point and melting point of a pure substance are the same. The table shows the melting points of some common substances. Water melts and freezes at 0 degrees Celsius. However, if another substance like salt or sugar is dissolved in water, its freezing point becomes lower because the solute particles interfere with the crystal formation of the solvent. Ice cream peddlers add salt on the ice around the ice cream container. Why?
In the 넌 이미 가까워진 듯 느껴져 이 순간